Hey guys, it's Megan from Jamie Reviews, here to give you the best of 2019.
Everybody, this is Noah, aka Young Noah. I'm here at Jamie Reviews today, and we are going to do our best of 2019. Let's get it going.
Hey y'all, it's Mary Beth. I'm here to bring you my top picks of 2019.
Yes, indeed, we are back. It is that time of the year for the best of the year of 2019. And this time, I brought some of your favorites from the channel. Let's get right into it with the best of 2019, starting off with our favorite shoe.
So, this was a very tough decision. What is my favorite shoe of 2019? We'll start off with my two honorable mentions. First, we have the Float Ride Run Fast Pro from Reeboks. This shoe is incredibly light. It was very comfortable for me when I was racing a half marathon, so it was a really great racing shoe. Also on my list of favorite shoes for 2019 is the Skechers Speed Trail. This shoe is extremely comfortable. It hugged my foot, and it really had some great grip for the trail running. But the winner of my favorite shoe in 2019 is the New Balance Beacon 2. This shoe, very versatile, comfortable, lightweight, and I could enjoy it in any run I did, whether it be tempos or long runs.
All right, everybody, there's been a lot of shoes this year, a lot of good ones, a lot of bad ones. My personal favorite of 2019 has been the Hoka Raycon. I think it's the most versatile everyday trainer out there. It's lightweight, you can do your speed work, but it's comfortable enough to do your long work in. I'm gonna throw you two more honorable mentions. I like the Nike Zoom Fly 3. That's the best running shoe Nike's released this year. Also, the Reebok Float Ride Run Fast. It is an excellent trainer. Reebok could have a great 2020.
This was tough. I ran in a lot of different shoes this year, and there were some good contenders, but I would say my favorite shoe of 2019 was the New Balance Beacon. I pretty much destroyed mine. I wore them for all of Hood to Coast, pretty much all of my summer miles. I found that this shoe does really well on pavement, but then it also does well on like bark trails, which is what I do a lot of my runs on. Super lightweight, which I love. I really loved this shoe. If I could give an honorable mention, I would probably give it to the Brooks Levitate 3. I just picked up a pair of those about a month ago, and I've already put some good miles on it. I think it's a big improvement from the last Levitate. And as always, it's a nice responsive option at an 8 millimeter drop, which feels pretty nice for going fast or for more like maintenance style easy runs.
So my favorite shoe of 2019 was pretty tough because I like a lot of shoes. So a lot of things get Jameson approved. But there is one that stood out, the Skechers Go Run Ride 8 Hyper. Now you're probably saying, Jamie, you're always Skechers, or Skechers that. You dang right, because they give the people what they want. And I appreciate that. The price did go up, but it's still worth the money. I like it. This is my third pair. I got the blue, the gray, the highlighter green. I got all the colors, so you can't go wrong. But honorable mention, I gotta show some love to New Balance Rebel. As far as being a lightweight, faster shoe, you can't go wrong with that one. If I could pick one, which, you know, hopefully everyone in the video is pick one shoe, Skechers Go Run Ride 8.
For my favorite brand of 2019, was also a very tough decision for me. It was really between two brands. I'm gonna have to go with New Balance though. I really loved the Beacon, and I felt like that was such a comfortable shoe. I had some really great spikes from them, the MD-800, and you know I'm a track runner, so I always like to have some nice pair of spikes. And then the New Balance Rebel was also a really comfortable shoe that was very versatile. Honorable mention brand, I don't have to go with Skechers. They put out some really great shoes. I love their trail shoe. I love the Speed 6. I felt like the shoes were very comfortable. It had a nice springiness to them, and that's always important to me.
All right, so my favorite brand of 2019 is going to have to be Hoka. Hoka is the innovation that excites. I mean, they came out with the Raycon, which is my best shoe of the year. You have the OG Clifton, which is one of the most fundamentally great high cushion shoes for your long distance runs. They're pulling in the carbon fiber plate with the Carbon X. There's a lot of things different that really put Hoka on the competitive running map.
So this kind of fits with the last category, but my favorite brand of 2019 was for sure New Balance. If you watched the 1080 review, Jameson and I talked about this a little bit. But yeah, New Balance just kind of blew me away this year. They had great options kind of at all across the spectrum. The New Balance at 80 was a shoe I ended up running in a lot just because it's really easy to throw on and go. Obviously the Beacon was a favorite for me. The new 1080, super nice. If you haven't watched our review of it, you should. That's been a great shoe for me. And I always love the Zante because I love a really firm, responsive shoe, and the Zante Pursuit is an awesome option. So across the board, New Balance just really impressed me. So they are definitely my brand of the year for 2019.
So when it comes to brand of the year in the running shoe game, it's pretty easy. I'm going with ASICS. ASICS had so many good things happen this year. They had the, okay, who am I kidding? I'm going New Balance. They had the Rebel. They had the Beacon 2. They had the 1080 V10, the FeelSeal Propel. And the only thing they had that was kind of trash was New Balance more, but we'll forget about that one. But as an overall arsenal of shoes, they had the most firepower. New Balance, you win 2019. But ASICS, come on, 2020 is our year. I'm feeling it.
Favorite apparel for 2019 is the Runnin' Rabbit Strap-tastic. This is a very comfortable tank top. I love the Runnin' Rabbit apparel. I find it very good quality, very comfortable, light and breathable. For bottoms, I really like the Vuori joggers. They're extremely soft. You just want to cuddle with them all day and never take them off. They're lightweight, comfortable, and very soft. Very soft. They're just soft.
Favorite piece of apparel for 2019 is the new Power Beats Pro. They're earbuds, but I still wear them. I think we count them as apparel. They're awesome. They fit right, great in your ears. They don't shake around when you run. I'm really picky with the kind of earbuds that I use. It's got great audio quality. Another hidden gem for you, the Power Beats 3, which is the previous model, you can get for less than $100. So Beats makes some great running earbuds. I highly recommend checking those out.
Oh, my favorite apparel item. I'm rocking it in the Freedom 3 review. It's the Wazelle Flyout Long Sleeve. My favorite version is the green color, but I have it in a couple different colors, but it's like the best lightweight layer ever. Dudes, if you're watching this, I'm sorry, they do not make it in men's sizes. It's ladies only, but I tend to love everything Wazelle does, but this shirt especially has been like a go-to. It's a lightweight long sleeve, so you can wear it on cold days or maybe just like a chilly summer morning and then strip it off after like a warm-up mile. But yeah, I wear that thing all the time.
Now, as far as my favorite running apparel, that's kind of tough because the boy likes apparel. But if I had to pick one thing, I'm gonna go with running shorts. Shout out to Chicken Legs running shorts. They have all the fantastic, obnoxious, weirdo colorways. But I mean, what guy doesn't wanna run in rubber duckies? You gotta have a lot of confidence to do so. So, your boy's down with it. You got the pineapples, the rubber ducks, the bread shorts. You see them all in my reviews. You see them, Megan wears some. You seen Vinnie Ray. You seen Young Gretchen. We all got them. And you know, they're not crazy priced. They're like $35, which isn't too bad considering like some shorts out there are like $80. Tracksmith. Anyway, Chicken Leg running shorts.
My favorite running accessory of 2019 is the Garmin 245 Music with a custom strap, because you know I like yellow. It can upload automatically to Strava if you're about that. So you can see if you win all the segments, the Strava segment. Win all the Strava segments.
My favorite accessory for 2019 is actually more of a snack. The Goo Gel, the blackberry flavor right here. This has gotta be the best gel flavor I use on my long runs. Back when I was marathon training, this was essential. And just the sweetness of the fruity blackberry, but it's still got that tart little aftertaste. Fantastic, gotta check this out.
Favorite watch slash accessory. For me, it was a watch, the Garmin Instinct. Been my go-to. I picked it up last like April or May. So I've had it a couple months and I love it because I do a lot of hiking, trail running, stuff in the outdoors, and it's done really well for me. It has an on-screen altimeter, which is super cool. And the battery life is great. And it's just a little bit more rugged. So I definitely tend to like throw my watch into my backpack and it gets tossed around. And the Instinct has been the first Garmin that's been able to really hold up to that kind of treatment. So it's been a great watch for me.
Now, as far as my favorite accessory for running, I'm gonna go with the Hypervolt because that thing means business. I mean, I know there's like 40 different versions of these from other brands, but this one's quiet. It's like, hey, are you tight? Your muscles are a little tired? Let me just boop, 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 fix that for you. Not that, no, that's too much. I like quiet things. Look at that, look at that. Just subtle, little buzz, like little bees.
The shoe I'm looking forward to most in 2020 is the Kinvara 11. And yes, I know, I've already been running in it, but I really love this shoe, and I couldn't say it in the 2019 reviews because it's not out yet. So I'm really looking forward to this coming out in 2020, even though I already have it.
My most anticipated running shoe for next year, 2020, has gotta be the Saucony Endorphin Speed. So Hoka was my favorite brand of this year. I think Saucony's got next. They got a bunch of great stuff going on. The Endorphin Speed is gonna be a performance trainer. It's got a whole new foam. I can't wait to check it out.
I am most looking forward to in 2020. This is probably not gonna come as a surprise, but it's the release of the Freedom 3. I've really enjoyed my time with the Freedom 3 so far. I've had it for about 2 weeks and already put some good miles on it. And I'm just excited for all of you to have access to it and be able to give us your feedback and your thoughts on it, because I think it's a really solid shoe. Obviously, it's the return of an OG, one of my favorite shoes. So I'm psyched for that to hit the market in 2020. I think it's coming out in February, so. Look out for that coming out soon.
What shoe am I looking most forward to in 2020? It's a lot of stuff coming out. I mean, the Pegasus 37 looks interesting. I've actually seen it. I mean, I'm looking forward to the A6 Nimbus Lite, but I am going with the Saucony Endorphin Pro. And I'm not a guy who's like racing a lot. I'm not a guy who's like, yeah, I need carbon plates. But that shoe, when I tried at the running event, it seems promising. It had a good fit, at least for what I had it on for. And you know, maybe next year I'll do some races. A half marathon, some 10Ks, a full marathon. Who am I kidding? Stop it. But yeah, I'm looking forward to that shoe. Endorphin Pro. Can't wait.
Thank you guys coming. Noah Dennis Heatcheck here. Appreciate y'all for tuning in. I love you, Mom. I'll be back 2020. Let's keep it tight.
So guys, that's my best of 2019. Thanks for watching. We'll see you next year in 2020.
All right, guys. That is everybody. That is everyone. Those are our top 2019 picks. Please let us know your top pick in each category. Favorite running shoe, favorite running accessory, whatever it may be, let me know down in the comment section down below, because there's been so much stuff that came out this year, we can't get it all. But yeah, you can follow everyone on Instagram, links down below. And with that said, be sure to stay in school, don't do drugs, and if you can, well, year's almost up, so maybe in 2020 you can try again and maybe get the next year right. Once you get there in 2020, keep it
okay, here we go. This is kind of weird not having a co-host.